Hello everyone. So in this session, I am going to solve the problem is based on simple stress and simple strain. So you can see the question on the display. So let us read the question. A straight uniform bar of AD is clamped at the both the ends, A and D, as shown in the figure. Initially, the bar is stress-free, means before applying the loads, the bar is free. Determine the stresses in all the three parts AB, BC and CD. We have to calculate the stresses in all these parts, like say sigma AB, sigma BC and sigma CD. You have to calculate of the bar. If the cross sectional area of the bar is given as 1000 millimeter square, means the bar is uniform, the entire section of the bar is uniform, so the area will be same for all these three sections. Like for A1, it will be say 1000 millimeter square, where A1, A2 is equal to again 1000 millimeter square, and A3 will be 1000 millimeter square, means it is common for all the sections. Now the Young's modulus, that is E. So E is not mentioned in the question, so that will be the same for all the materials. Means let us assume the bar is having a homogeneous property, so the material property Young's modulus will be same for the entire bar. Okay, so let us write the given data. A1, A2, A3 is equal to 1000 millimeter square. And you have to calculate what will be the stress at AB, what will be the stress at BC and the stress at CD. These things you have to calculate. Okay, so now look at the given figure. So here the force at the both the ends, it is rigidly fixed with A and D, and two forces are acting at an B and at an C. At B it is acting a 5 kN and at C it is 10 kN. So now we have to make the separate portion of all these three sections. So we have to draw a free body diagram. Diagram for three sections. So for the first section, A and B. Okay, so here at the right side it is acting 5 kN and left side there will be reaction forces. So let us consider the reaction forces one side and another side, that is RA at the right side, RD because it is D here at the another end. So all the forces are under equilibrium. Okay, and they are acting at the left side, means let us take the moment all the forces at the left side, means at the A. Okay, so the reaction force at the left side is RA. And what about the reaction forces, what about the force at the right side? Okay, so write down the reaction forces at the right side. So at the point of B, acting a 5 kN and there is a one reaction forces, it is going to be under compression. Okay, means one force is acting as a tensile load, that is 5 kN, another there is a force 10 kN acting at C, means here it is 5 plus 10 minus RD. Okay, 5 kN, 10 kN minus the reaction forces, because it is an acting compression force. Okay, so it will be 15 kN minus RD. Okay, so just write down it is 15 minus RD. Okay, for the second portion, so second portion, Here one force is acting compression, another force it is acting and tensile at the portion B and C. So one it is acting under tensile force, that you can see it is 10 kilonewton. So 10 minus another it acting opposite of 10, so it is minus RD. Okay, similarly at the left side also it will be 10 minus RD. Okay, now for the portion 3, okay, AB, it is BC, now it is CD. At the portion 3, you can directly see RD is acting under compression load, right? So there will be one more force which is acting compressly from the left side also. Okay, so now the forces at the portion 1 is 15 minus RD, and forces at the portion B, let us say 1, 2 and 3. So at the B it is 10 minus RD, at the C it is just RD. Okay, now make the forces are under equilibrium. So now we have calculated the forces for each portions, that is AB and BC and CD. So we got RD value in all the forces. So now you have to find out what is the reaction force at D. Okay, because this will be considered as a force F1, and this will be considered as F2 and F3. Okay, now calculate what is RD. From the reaction forces, hence it is equilibrium condition. So I can write where RA plus RD is equal to 5 plus 10. It is equal to 15 kilonewton. Okay, let delta L1, delta L2 and delta L3 are the change in length or extension of AB, BC and CD respectively. Okay, as we know from the Hooke's law, where delta L is equal to, it is PL divided by AE. So this will be the universal formula. As we know, change in length is equal to load into length of the bar divided by area of the cross section into Young's modulus. Okay, now I will write separately for each portion. So let us say delta L1 for the portion 1 is equal to P. So we have calculated P is equal to 15 minus RD into LAB, the length of the portion AB divided by A. A is 1000 millimeter square is given in the question, and Young's modulus will be same for the all the portions. So let us say equation number 1. So here the delta 1 is getting extension. So let us say plus, it is increasing here. And in the second case, delta L2, again it is 10 minus RD into length for with BC divided by 1000 into E second. So here also the portion is going to be increasing, means it is going to be elongated. Now for the third portion, delta L3, where force is taken as RD into length for the CD divided by 1000 into Young's modulus. The third case is changed here. It is going to be get compressed, means negative, means decreasing. Decrease. Okay. Since the supports are rigid, so therefore the elongation of AB and BC are equal to the compression CD. Compression CD means equation 1 and 2 are going to be add and is equal to the equation 3. Means delta L1 plus delta L2 is equal to delta L3. Now substitute all the three equation, 15 minus RD into LB. So you can substitute the value of LB, the length of the portion 1, that is 600, length of the portion 2, that is 500, length for the portion 3, 400. So substitute all the length here. So first it is 600 divided by area is 1000 into angst modulus plus 10 minus RD into the length is 500 divided by 1000 into angst modulus is equal to